Hello friends, today we are going to work on the Cisco Packet Tracer. We are going to work on protocol name RIP, Routing Information Protocol. The structure for the diagram, the structure is already created. Number, the labeling for the same routers as well as for the PCs is given. Routing Information Protocol is nothing but providing routing the IP information towards each and every router so that packet can transmit it from one device to another from in the network. If you see, we are already given some IP address to this particular router 10.1. We have to give the fast Ethernet IP addresses for the routers as well. So the IP address for the router is, for fast Ethernet, is 16.0.0.1, then here for this 17.0.0.1, and here is 18.0.0.1. As we have given the proper labeling to each and every router and each every link, we will start with the configuration. First, we'll do the configure our PC. Go to the PC, desktop, IP configuration, static IP address, or you can just, so the IP address for the first PC is 16.0.0.2. Subnet mask. It will ask us for the default gateway. Default gateway is nothing but the IP address of the router, that is fast Ethernet. It will be 16.0.0.1. For this PC we have done, we'll go to the next PC, desktop, IP configuration, IP address for the PC is 17.0.0.2. Subnet mask will appear. Default gateway is 17.0.0.1. In examination, they will provide you the IP address. If they not, then you can give your own IP addresses according to your requirements or according to your specification. IP address for the third PC is 18.0.0.2. Subnet mask, default gateway will be 18.0.0.1. As we have configured our all three PCs, now we need to configure our routers. IP address is already labeled. So how to configure it? You can configure our routers using CLI mode or by configuration mode. First of all, we go with the configuration mode. So in configuration mode, we first see the serial SE2/0. We go to serial SE2/0. We have given IP address 10.0.0.1, 10.0.0.1. Subnet mask. As the clock is appear, you can set a clock at 64,000. Make it on. Then go to the fast Ethernet 0/0. Fast Ethernet 0/0 for the same router. IP address is nothing but the default gateway, that is 16.0.0.1. Subnet mask and on. If you see, the color has been changed to red to orange, then it will convert to green to green. Now we need to go for router number 2. In router number 2, we have seen, if you see how many connections are there, we'll go to the configuration first. Serial 2/0, 2/0. The IP address for 2/0 is 10.0.0.2. 10.0.0.2. Subnet mask, as there is no clock, we no need to set the clock. Just on the link. If you see, the link is converted to red to green. Now we need to check fast Ethernet 0/0. Fast Ethernet 0/0 for the router number 2 will be 17.0.0.1. Again, we have to on the status, it will keep on changing the color. Same thing for this router, we have two serial cables, serial SE2/0 and serial SE3/0, which have one clock. So serial SE3/0, IP address for the same is 11.0.0.1, 11.0.0.1. Subnet mask, give the IP or set the clock to 64,000. On the clock, close, go to the last router, configuration mode, serial 2/0, IP address for the same is 11.0.0.2. Default gateway, submit mask, on the clock, fast ethernet 0/0, fast ethernet 0/0, it is 18.0.0.1. Subnet mask, on the connection, close. As we have done the configuration of all the router, now we have to work right now on the RIP. So how to work on the RIP? Go to the router, RIP routing information protocol. It will ask you the network of router. For this router, network is 16.0.0.0. Again, we have serial cable. For that, the network will be 10.0.0.0. So network for this router is 16.0.0.0. Add another network for this router is 10.0.0.0. Add, go to the setting, save, close. Now come to the router number 2. You can check what are the different networks are available in CLI mode. Exit. Set. Come to the router. You can give the command, say show IP root, enter. It will show you the IP root, that is 10, 11 and 17. We have three networks, 10.0.0, 11.0.0 and 17.0.0. So go to the configuration, go to the RIP. First is 10.0.0.0, add. Second is 11.0.0.0, add. Third is 17 series, 17.0.0.0, add. All three added, go to the setting, save the connection, close, go to the router 3. We know what are the networks, 18 series and 11 series. So go to the RIP, click 11.0.0.0, add. Another network is 18.0.0.0, add. Go to setting, save the connection, close. As we have done with the configuration as well as the configuration of RIP on individual routers, so we will check now whether a packet can flow in the network or not. From this PC to this PC, it's showing progress, failed, still it is not completed or created its own table. Now it will show you the results, it's successful. I'll delete the connection. Now I'll go to this PC to this PC, it's progressing. I'll delete the connection and check again. It's showing me the successful, that is the whole connection using RIP is completed. So you can add one more router in this connection and work for the same. By using RIP, you can add one more router here, any generic or any other router you can add, and do the connection and do it using RIP. I hope you understand this working of routing information protocol. Please do practice, add one more router and do the connection. Thank you so much. Take care.